Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, this week's edition of Horses and Courses, 21 races to bring you, four stops on the calendar. Let's get to opening day, Friday at Caneland, three-year-olds on the turf in the Transylvania.
And they're off in the Transylvania, presented by Caneland Select. Profiteer away in good order, but Sonic Boom moves up, and Holiday Stone and Oscar Performance is right there toward the inside as well to press the issue in the opening strides. Holiday Stone moves forward from the outside and has the lead by almost a full length heading into the first turn. Sonic Boom wants to move forward and now moves up into second on the outside. Oscar Performance moves down to the rail, saves ground from third, just a length and a half off the leader around that first turn. Cowboy Culture caught wide in fourth, nearly three lengths off the lead. Big score fifth between horses. Profiteer shuffled back a couple of positions into sixth, flanked by Ticonderoga, seventh, gap of three more back to Macarios, eighth and last, 23 and 4/5 seconds for the opening quarter. Holiday Stone against the rail leads it up the backstretch by just over a length. Sonic Boom second on the outside, three parts of a length. Oscar Performance hugs the rail to the inside of horses in third, three parts of a length. Cowboy Culture fourth to the far outside. Big score fifth. Profiteer sixth against the rail. Still flanked there by Ticonderoga. Gap of just over two more back to Macarios. 48 and 2/5 seconds the time for the first half mile. Holiday Stone the leader, three parts of a length midway on the far turn. Sonic Boom second up on the outside. Side. Cowboy Culture asks for more now. Oscar Performance is still toward the rail in fourth. Two lengths off the lead. Has room to run, though, as they come off the far turn, but has to catch Holiday Stone. Big score in behind horses in fourth. Sonic Boom is still there on the outside. Big score needing room. Oscar Performance lingering. Final furlong of the Transylvania. Holiday Stone has the lead, and Big Score is coming on from the outside. From far back, Macarios charging toward third. Here's Big Score chasing after Holiday Stone. And Big Score wins the Transylvania for Javier Castellano.
And for those of us that like the 34-1 shot, Javier Castellano got us on a 10-1 shot. Big Score returns $22.40. First start since the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Turf. Holiday Stone made all the running at nearly 35-1, just gets run down. Macarios at nearly 40-1 comes from last to third. Oscar Performance, the 7-10 favorite, finishes fifth in the Transylvania. Saturday afternoon, a terrific day of racing at Caneland. Up first, sprinters in the Commonwealth.
They're off in the Commonwealth. Yaki's Warrior away running for the early lead. Fish Trap Road is there toward the inside. Limousine Liberal between those two. AP Indian up close to the far outside. And Reedsdale comes out running in fourth. Here's Limousine Liberal up to take the lead up the backstretch. Leads at three parts of a length. Yaki's Warrior second three parts of a length. Reedsdale third ahead. Fish Trap Road fourth toward the inside. AP Indian fifth to the far outside. Gap of two to Tale of Saval, who moves up one position into sixth just inside of a Amiz Flatter, who finds himself in seventh, gap of three. Awesome Slew travels in eighth, riding in the wind ninth, 22 and 4/5 seconds the time for the opening quarter. Yaki's Warrior on the outside of Limousine Liberal to contest the top spot around the far turn. Reedsdale, three lanes off the rail in third, a length and a half off the lead. AP Indian moves up fourth, has to go wide to the top of the stretch throughout the quarter pole. Gap of two to Fish Trap Road. Amiz Flatter desperately trying to pick up the leaders. Awesome Slew swings wide outside of that one. Meanwhile, AP Indian has taken the lead from Reedsdale in second. Limousine Liberal third. Final furlong, Awesome Slew still there on the far outside and still coming on. AP Indian, Awesome Slew striding forward for Joel Rosario. Had it measured perfectly. Awesome Slew to win it. AP Indian was home second. Limousine Liberal third, close for fourth.
And on the outside, running late, Awesome Slew. Second choice in the wagering scores the victory for Mark Cassie, Live Oak, Joel Rosario, $8.20 over the 9-5 favorite AP Indian. Limousine Liberal finishes third. Over to turf sprinting action up next in the Grade 2 Shakertown.
And they're off in the Shakertown. Partly Mocha was off slowly. Mongolian Saturday and Justin Squared have early speed with Shockimot right there on the far outside to join the top two. And then a break of 2.5 lengths to Green Mask outward from the rail and fourth in the opening strides, fourth a half length. And then Holding Gold fifth to the inside. Hoagie sixth on the outside, now taking fifth within 5 lengths of the leader. Partly Mocha moves up a couple of spots into the 7th position. And then Rainbow Air. And Rainbow Air is next to last. Element trails 22 seconds. The time for the opening quarter. Justin Squared is the leader. Mongolian Saturday a length away between horses. Second, Shockimot, length and a half off the lead. Far outside in third. Green Mask looks for an opening toward the rail in fourth. Hoagie is fifth on the outside. And here is Green Mask trying to find an opening inside of Justin Squared up to challenge and Holding Gold. Holding Gold is up to third, trying to catch Green Mask. Holding Gold is coming forward. Further back, Hoagie third. Holding Gold right alongside Green Mask. Holding Gold. What a day for these connections. Holding Gold wins the Shakertown.
Mark Cassie, Live Oak Plantation, Joel Rosario. No, the needle isn't stuck. This time at 18-1. Holiday Gold returns $38.20. For the photo finish victory over the third choice, Green Mask. Hoagie, the 3-1 favorite, finishes third. Up next, older filly mare sprinting in the Grade 1 Madison.
They're off in the Madison. Cat Ballou and Ponder Lee have early speed. Constellation up close in between those two in the opening strides as well, with Minds and Magic away fourth up on the extreme outside. Constellation between horses has the lead by a neck. Ponder Lee alongside to the outside, and there's Cat Ballou regaining second down toward the inside. Further back, Paula's Silver Lining moves up in between horses and fourth, just 2 lengths off the lead. Minds and Magic fifth on her outside. Paid Up Subscriber is sixth back toward the inside. High Ridge Road, Wheatfield, close fall off. Opening quarter, 23 seconds as they move for the far turn with Constellation leading it by 3 parts of a length. Cat Ballou, then Ponder Lee up on the outside. Paula Silver Lining and Minds and Magic, who's fifth, now taking fourth. 3 lanes off the rail, 3 lengths off the lead. Paid Up Subscriber next, then Wheatfield, High Ridge Road, and close fall off as last they turn for home. Constellation leading it by 2 lengths off the turn. Minds and Magic moves up second up on the outside. Ponder Lee third. Paula Silver Lining dives to the inside from fourth and comes after Constellation. Paula's Silver Lining trying to reel in Constellation at the eighth pole. Paula's Silver Lining strides forward, has the lead. Paid Up Subscriber runs late toward the outside, then Cat Ballou back toward the inside. Constellation not finished yet. Paula's Silver Lining got ahead in front. Constellation fights on, but Paula's Silver Lining wins it by a neck over Constellation in 1 minute 23 and 3/5 seconds.
Paula's Silver Lining for Chad Brown, Judmon, and Jose Ortiz. The 9-5 favorite, the offspring of Ghost Zapper, wins the photo finish, returning $5.60. Constellation finishes second. Pay Up Subscriber finishes third. One more before the break. 3-year-old fillies in one of the premier preps for the Kentucky Oaks, the Ashland.
They're off in the Central Bank Ashland. Subday Soon is quick end stride, comes right out for the lead. Sailor's Valentine there toward the outside. Pretty City Dancer gets away in third. Elate is away fourth, quickly settles against the rail for that move into the first turn. Someday Soon is the leader. Someday Soon leads it by just a length. Sailor's Valentine moves up toward the outside to challenge Elate for that second spot now, and they're going to be joined by Tap, who is 3 wide around the first turn, forwardly placed into fourth, around Pretty City Dancer in fifth. Daddy's Little Darling, sixth back toward the inside. Meanie Irene is seventh alongside her. Summer Luck, 3 wide at the back off the first turn, moves up 2 spots from last. 24 2/5 seconds, the time for the opening quarter, and Someday Soon is the leader. Someday Soon is on top 3 parts of a length. Sailor's Valentine inching forward in second a length. Elate is third by a neck, and then Tapped is fourth right alongside of her. Pretty City Dancer, Daddy's Little Darling against the rail. Summer Luck next to last. Meanie Irene trails. It was 49 1/5 seconds for the opening half mile. Someday soon, the leader, 3/4 of a length into the far turn. Sailor's Valentine tapped to the outside. Pretty City Dancer wide on the far turn and fourth, just over 3 lengths off the lead. Elate gets the shuffle back into fifth. Daddy's Little Darling has 8 lengths to make up along with Summer Luck, and they're coming to the top of the short stretch. Someday soon, trying to take it all the way here, and leads it coming toward the eighth pole on top by a length. Sailor's Valentine is still trying, still second. They bump into the final furlong. Sailor's Valentine alongside and now puts a head in front of Someday Soon. Daddy's Little Darling is running late from third. Deep stretch of the Central Bank, Ashland. Sailor's Valentine, Daddy's Little Darling, Sailor's Valentine wins it a half length for Corey Lannery.
And maybe not so much this year with the premier prep race for the Oaks. You saw Elate, the even money favorite, back out on the turn. She was vanned off after not finishing the race, as did Mini Irene. But the winner at 22-1, Sailor's Valentine, Eddie Keneally, Corey Lannery, 46-40. Daddy's Little Darling finishes second. Someday Soon finishes third. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, more three-year-old action from Keeneland and a stop at Oaklawn Park.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love rate.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTV's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTV mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play. In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Hey, we've got a new show.
We do.
Absolutely, And They're Off, right here on the OTV TV network Sunday morning.
What's it all about?
It'll be a lot of fun. Fast-paced, plenty of topics, guests, handicapping, commentary, and maybe some opinions.
I have opinions on my opinions.
And we will have plenty of them because you're on the show. And They're Off, Sunday mornings here on the OTV TV network, 10 a.m. each Sunday. Should be a lot of fun. Anthony Mormino, Seth Merrill, we'll see you there.
I'm sorry, I went... Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Continuing on at Keeneland. Up next, the Bluegrass.
And they're off in the Toyota Bluegrass Stakes. Wild Shot comes right out for the lead. IRAP is there. Practical Joke up on the outside as well to press the issue. These three come to the front as the field heads into the first turn. Wild Shot gets over to the rail, has the lead. IRAP moves up just off his flank into the second position. There's McCracken, third in between horses early. Third by just ahead, just a length and a half off the lead. It's your nickel fourth to the inside. Practical Joke is fifth toward the outside of McCracken. Taprit is in sixth position. J Boy's Echo seventh right there with the rest. Opening quarter went in 23 3/5 seconds. Wild Shot, the leader, 3/4 of a length up the back stretch, and IRAP toward the outside and in the clear in second. It's your nickel goes third a half length. He's got McCracken right there alongside in the fourth position by a half length. Practical Joke stays right with McCracken. Now Practical Joke is going to make his move right now. He moves up from fifth to fourth to third within 2 lengths of the lead. Gets around the outside of McCracken, leaves room at the inside for It's Your Nickel. J Boy's Echo between horses moves up in close quarters, and Taprit last and wide at the back end of the far turn. Long Shot IRAP has the lead. The opening half mile was 48 1/5 seconds. Wild Shot, then Practical Joke. McCracken is still fourth. Taprit is fifth on his outside. Let's see what they can do. They've got to catch Long Shot IRAP at the top of the stretch, who leads it by 2 lengths. Practical Joke second, McCracken third, Taprit fourth on the outside, J Boy's Echo in fifth. Here's McCracken storming up on the outside. IRAP is fighting on, and Practical Joke is in between those two. Final furlong of the Toyota Bluegrass. IRAP with the lead. Practical Joke giving all he's got. IRAP 31-1 wins the Toyota Bluegrass with Julian Leperoux aboard. 1:50.15.
And a race that may have had the most names has the maiden no more. IRAP, the maiden, at 31-1. The second longest shot on the board behind It's Your Nickel, who was 32-1. But IRAP, up front on the pace, scores by 3/4 of a length for Doug O'Neill, Redham Racing, Julian Leperoux, $64.60. Practical Joke, I thought a good second for a horse that I thought has two turn limitations. And McCracken, the 8-5 favorite, tastes defeat for the first time, finishing third. Up next, 3-year-old fillies in the Beaumont.
And they're off in the Adena Springs Beaumont. Promise is broken away quickly from the outside. My Mischief has early speed. Treble is up close, and Sine Wave, who comes away running in the fourth position. Headed up the backstretch now. Promises Broken has the lead, gets over to the inside, leading Sine Wave 3/4 of a length. Now here's Sweet Loretta. Broke toward the back of the pack, moves up a couple of spots to the inside of My Mischief to challenge that one for the third spot. Treble joins them to the outside, a close-up fifth. Dancing Rags in sixth, and Laney seventh and last. But Promise is Broken is the leader, 23 2/5 seconds. The time for the opening quarter, leading Sine Wave, 3/4 of a length. Sweet Loretta hugs the rail in third, a length off the lead, into the far turn. Treble to the far outside in fourth. Now moves up once again, challenging for the third position. My Mischief is there, fighting on from fifth. Now fourth, in between horses, Dancing Rags, 5 lengths off the lead, and next to last, with Laney trailing to the top of the stretch, and Promise is Broken, and Sine Wave going at it. Sweet Loretta stays down toward the inside, looks for running room there. My Mischief behind horses, Treble is still there, far outside, but still fifth. Sweet Loretta finds an opening, starts moving up the rail to challenge Promise is Broken, and Sine Wave with My Mischief in fourth, final furlong. Sweet Loretta kicking clear with a 3-length lead, and the Adena Springs Beaumont. Sweet Loretta just past the 16th pole, maintaining that 3-length margin, and Sweet Loretta takes it for Javier Castellano. Sine Wave was home second. Laney rallied up on the outside for third, over Promises Broken fourth, 1:27.3.
Sweet Loretta, Todd Pletcher, Javier Castellano, they win by three, returning $4.40 as the favorite. Sine Wave finishes second. Laney finishes third. All right, out to Oaklawn Park as they kick off the Racing Festival of the South, the Carousel.
They're at the post. They're off. Chanteline wins the break and goes for the front. DRC's Pretty Sky and Pleasant Tales away second and third. Illusion Artist breaks fourth, and Marquee Miss and Athena, and the early trailer is Natural Wonder. Chanteline up the backstretch, a tight length in front, now a length and a half. Chanteline leads into the far turn in the 38th running of the Carousel. She's a length and a quarter in front of Pleasant Tales in second. DRC's Pretty Sky is third now and two from the front. Marquee Miss is fourth. She's in the orange and about three off the lead. Illusion Artist has dropped back to fifth with 5 lengths to make up. Athena is angled to the inside. She's second to last with 6 lengths to close and only a quarter mile to do it. Natural Wonder is the trailer, and Chanteline gets away at the top of the stretch. Chanteline now a solid 3-length lead. From Pleasant Tales, Illusion Artist at the rail. Athena's closing now, but she's still 4.5 behind Chanteline inside the final furlong. Now from the inside, and Illusion Artist trying to run by Chanteline. Illusion Artist takes the lead. Chanteline is second. Illusion Artist. The 38th Carousel goes to Illusion Artist, a length and a half over Chanteline. Athena was third, and Pleasant Tales fourth.
Illusion Artist, Richard Aramius, scores the upset victory, returning $21.40. Chanteline finishes second as the second choice in the wagering, and the 9-5 favorite, Athena, finishes third. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, headed out west for the big weekend stakes action from Santa Anita.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Not at the track and not near a computer? No problem. Wager with Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System and you'll never get shut out again. Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System is quick, simple to use, and guarantees your wagers are accurate and placed on time. For more information, visit CapitalOTB.com or call Capital OTB's customer service hotline at 800-292-BETS. Capital OTB's Touchtone Wagering System. Never get shut out again.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Head out to the Great Race Place. Up first, Cowbreds in the Evening Jewel.
Racing. Miss Sunset flies out of gate 8. Chipino Pasadino going fast with My California Radish, and SY Sky is next, followed by Adios Cali, Star of Quality, and You're Late. Miss Sunset, the leader from Chipino Pasadino by a length and a half onto the main track. Then My California, SY Sky deep. Radish towards the inside, 3.5 lengths off the pace, followed by Adios Cali, You're Late, and 3 lengths, Star of Quality. Miss Sunset along to the half mile pole by 2 lengths. Now the first time starter making a move, SY Sky ranging up out wide to second, past Chipino Pasadino with Radish one off the rail in fourth. Then comes Adios Cali in the pink colours, just held up behind that pair in front of her at the 3/8 pole. Your Late circles 3 wide from My California and 4 lengths to Star of Quality. Miss Sunset by a half length. SY Sky presenting herself as some kind of threat at the quarter pole. She's running a strong race on debut. A length and a half to Radish coming to the outside, clear of Chipino Pasadino, and next is Adios Cali, SY Sky and Miss Sunset together, and soon afterwards SY Sky in the front. Radish is finishing on well, and a long gap then to Star of Quality and Adios Cali, but SY Sky at first asking. Phil D'Amato unveiling a first timer to debut in a stakes race, and she won by 5 lengths from Radish, with Miss Sunset ahead back third and Star of Quality fourth.
And ladies and gentlemen, we knew it would happen. I think it's the first time in, boy, a long time, a debut winner of a stakes race on Horses and Courses. I got to tell you, the last time I remember that was about 30 years ago in the Bashford Manor. But Phil D'Amato, the good guy, Joe Talamo, they send out SY Sky for not only the debut, ladies and gentlemen, she wins by 5.5 as the third choice, returning 1480. Radish finishes second. Miss Sunset, the 3-5 favorite, finishes third. Over to the turf for the 1 mile Royal Heroine.
Racing. Hill House High, best into stride from Lady Valeur. Juno showing speed along the inside. Then comes Prize Exhibit on the inside of Harmonize, with a couple of lengths to Mocat covering Pretty Girl. Juno shoots clear of Hill House High, establishes a 2-length lead before they reach the first turn. Lady Valeur another 3 lengths off third. Juno going rapidly into that first bend, has dashed away by 4 lengths with 3/4 of a mile to go. Juno clear of Hill House High. Lady Valeur is third. Prize Exhibit fourth, would be 10 lengths off the lead. Harmonize has got some pace to chase, sitting back there third last from Pretty Girl and Mocat. At the 5/8 pole in the back stretch, and Juno, with a wing on every hoof, leads a half dozen lengths Hill House High. 2 lengths Lady Valeur, a length and a half to Prize Exhibit, joined by Harmonize, and then Pretty Girl on the inside of Mocat to the half-mile marker in the Royal Heroine. Juno, a 5-length leader over Hill House High. Lady Valeur third, Pretty Girl getting up along the inside, followed by Harmonize, who's out to the 3 path with 7 lengths to pick up at the 3/8 pole. Prize Exhibit splits runners, Mocat last. Around past the 5/16, Vincent Juno comes back to the pursuing pack. Hillhouse High ranging up within a half length. A length and a half, Pretty Girl hunting through towards the inside while Lady Valour eases three deep, and then Prize Exhibit harmonised second last with five lengths to pick up as Hillhouse High draws past Juno at the eighth pole, clear of Pretty Girl, Lady Valour, Prize Exhibit to the inside, harmonised, not really kicking in. Mocat finishing strongly. Hillhouse High in front. Mocat flying down the outside, but Hillhouse High beat Mocat half a length of Baltus Exacta. Juno held on to third. Harmonize applauding fourth.
And in the 19th running, we have the biggest mutual in here. Corey Nakatani aboard Hillside High. Richard Baltus has had a great last 12 months, ladies and gentlemen. $16.80. Mocat finishes second. Juno third. The 6-5 favorite, Harmonize, finishes fourth. And unfortunately, no Unique Bella, maybe perhaps for her. Up next, the Santa Anita Oaks.
Racing. Bernina Star had a stumbling start, and Abel Tasman was the last to hit the ground. Goes back three or four lengths behind the second last horse. It's Paradise Woods' Princess Karen disputing the early lead. From Mopetism, it is well. Bernina Star, majestic quality crossing to the rail, sixth and three lengths to Abel Tasman. 7/8 left to go, and Paradise Woods heads to a clear-cut lead. Princess Karen running second. They're the most lightly raced pair in the field, each rising sharply in distance, and they are 1-2 onto the back stretch, with Mopetism third, It Is Well fourth, one off the rail. 2.5 lengths then to the maiden, majestic quality. Abel Tasman on the move, now splitting horses in that rearward trio, with Bernina Star camped out three wide, past the 5/8 pole and Paradise Woods from Princess Karen. Then Mopetism, It Is Well, Bernina Star out wide from Abel Tasman, 4.5 off the lead, and majestic quality trails at the halfway point. It's Paradise Woods a length and a quarter. Princess Karen second. Then comes Bernina Star out wide on the track around It Is Well and Mopetism. A line of three sharing third. 2.5 lengths then to the last couple. Majestic quality and Abel Tasman's dropped out again. At the 5/16 pole, Paradise Woods a length and a half. From in second position, Princess Karen, who's joined either side by Bernina Star and Mopetism, then majestic quality in the green cap from It Is Well, and Abel Tasman on the extreme outside, getting forced very wide, 8 lengths off the lead. Paradise Woods has slipped away by 6 lengths. The others are in a line at the 8th pole, with Abel Tasman running home fairly well into second. But the masterful Mandela has produced Paradise Woods at start number 3 to a dazzling victory in the Santa Anita Oaks. She wins by a dozen lengths from Abel Tasman, third between Mopetism and It Is Well.
And a new winning margin of nearly a dozen lengths. Paradise Woods, Mandela, Pratt, they go to the front. She dials down and wins by 11¾, returning $18.20, defeating the 4-5 favorite, Abel Tasman. It Is Well, the second choice, the 2-1, finishes third. Up next, 13 in the Grade 1 Santa Anita Derby.
Set. Racing. Battle of Midway away beautifully from Gate 3. Royal Mo commences well, and up there too is American Anthem with Iliad, Gormley, and Midnight Pleasure about 6th. A couple of lengths to Soak Inflated, Milton Freewater, Kim Bear. Then comes Reach the World, 12 lengths off the early speed from Comma Sister, Irish Freedom, 3 wide, and Term of Art, 5 lengths last. Line of three at the 7/8 pole. Battle of Midway, American Anthem and Royal Mo. Stretched across the track, 4 lengths in front from Midnight Pleasure. Gormley dropping in fifth, being more conservatively ridden today. Iliad is behind him, some 8 lengths off the early pace. Then the grey Milton Freewater. Irish Freedom, 3 deep onto the back stretch from Soak Inflated, Comma Sister. Reach the World, Kim Bear, and 5 lengths to Term of Art at the 5/8 pole. And it's been an effervescent opening to the Derby as Battle of Midway, Royal Mo and American Anthem comprise a line of three sprightly leaders out by 6 lengths from in fourth position Midnight Pleasure, who covers Gormley. Another couple of lengths to Iliad, patiently ridden mid-pack from a 3-wide Irish Freedom. Next is Soak Inflated, Reach the World in the orange colours, inching forward around the outside, commencing a 3-wide move within 8 lengths of the lead. Kim Bear well back in the field. And back towards the rear, Milton Freewater and Term of Art. Battle of Midway, Royal Mo striding away from American Anthem. Gormley is being presented three wide within a length of them, swinging for home, and then Midnight Pleasure. Iliad and Reach the Stars coming with very wide bids. Less than 3/16 to go. Battle of Midway from Royal Mo. And here comes Gormley, followed by Iliad and Reach the World. It's Battle of Midway trying to stave off the Moss pair. Royal Mo and Gormley battling strongly. Gormley looming into the lead now. Gormley takes the lead. And Gormley wins the Santa Anita Derby. A half length to Battle of Midway. Royal Mo and Reach the World finished fourth just in front of Iliad.
Gormley, he gets the victory in the slowest Santa Anita Derby, I think, since Round Table got beat in the late 1950s. But Gormley gets the cash and the Grade 1 victory, returning $14.40. Battle of Midway finishes second. Royal Mo, and these are the horses up on the pace, finishes third. The 3-1 co-choices finished fourth and fifth. Iliad, the actual betting favorite, finishes fifth. Back to the turf, three-year-old fillies in the Providencia.
Stands better, racing. Sir Cat Sally and Princess Wah win the start together from emphatically Tibetina. You missed it on the inside, and back at the rear is War Moccasin, putting a furlong behind them. It's Sir Cat Sally on the inside, taking the lead by a length from Princess Wah. In third position, a length and a half off is emphatically as they greet the judges with the circuit of the Santa Anita turf course to negotiate. You missed its running fourth along the fence, followed by Tibetina and War Moccasin at the tail. Sir Cat Sally extends her advantage to a little over two lengths from Princess Wah, spinning around the first turn with emphatically third, just a steady tempo at the three-quarters pole. You missed it, the maidens running fourth, six lengths off the pace-setting favourite, three lengths Tibetina as they string out into single file, and at the tail is War Moccasin, 5/8 left to go, and it's Sir Cat Sally by a length and a half. In second spot, Princess Wah, Baltus and Nakatani seeking a graded stakes double after Hill House High took the Royal Heroine. In third spot is emphatically, you missed it, travelling along the rail, fourth with a half mile to go. She's followed by Tibetina and War Moccasin, last of the six, the field covered by a touch over six lengths. Sir Cat Sally has been left to her own devices on a clear-cut lead. She swings past the 3/8 pole, a length and a half to the good of Princess Wah, emphatically third. No change in the order. You missed it as fourth, Tibetina fifth, and War Moccasin a struggling sixth. Past the quarter pole, Sir Cat Sally, a one-length leader from Princess Wah, emphatically sliding forward three wide. You missed it running a forward race on the inside next at the 8th pole, and Sir Cat Sally in the front, yet to be asked for the supreme effort. From a line of three. You missed it on the inside, emphatically running on, but Sir Cat Sally, patient progression from Hollendorfer. Every time the bar is raised, she jumps. Second close, you missed it, or emphatically, and they were clear of Princess Wah.
Geez, I practice that stakes name every year, ladies and gentlemen, just for that moment, I booted it. But Sir Cat Sally, at 3-10, scores the comfortable front-end victory for Mike Smith and Jerry Hollendorfer. They return $2.60. You missed it, only by 2 1/4 lengths. Finishes second, emphatically finishes third. Back to Cowbreds, now with the boys, the Echo Eddie.
Racing. Mr. Hinks speedily away. Green with Eddie looking for the lead. Early pace coming from 99 proof in the orange cap. California Diamond, Elwood J right up amongst the early action. Will Tell sliding along the rail with B squared. We've got seven in line at the 5/8 pole. 99 proof now easing out of that line of leaders. Dr. Troutman back second last, Tribal Storm the trailer. At the half-mile pole, it's Will Tell, B squared, Mr. Hinks a line of three. Three-quarters of a length to a four-wide green with Eddie. California Diamond is five-wide, a length and a half off the pace. Followed into the turn by Elwood J, who's well off the speed today. He's about five lengths off the lead and racing wide around Dr. Troutman and 99 proof, and Tribal Storm is a half dozen lengths last. Still competitive at the quarter pole. B squared with a nose in the front. Will Tell's on his inside. Mr. Hinks, the three path. Green with Eddie, four wide. California Diamond, two lengths away. 99 proof next at the 8th pole. B squared, Mr. Hinks from Green with Eddie. Will Tell on the inside. California Diamond's going to be out of the exacta for the first time in his life. And it's a battle between Mr. Hinks and B squared. squared, B squared, Mr. Hinks. Mr. Hinks and B squared, a head bobbing finish to the Echo Eddie. I'll leave it to the judges, either B squared or Mr. Hinks. Tribal Storm flashing along the fence for third, then we'll tell.
Mr. Hinks, Tyler Bays wins the photo finish, returning $19 even. B squared finish second. Tribal Storm finishes third. The 6-5 favorite, California Diamond, finishes eighth in the Echo Eddie. All right, we're going to take our final break. When we come back, Raid 1 action returns to Aqueduct.
Hey, we've got a new show.
We do.
Absolutely. And They're Off right here on the OTB TV network Sunday mornings.
What's it all about?
It'll be a lot of fun. Fast paced, plenty of topics, guests, handicapping, commentary, and maybe some opinions.
I have opinions on my opinions.
And we will have plenty of them because you're on the show. And They're Off Sunday mornings here on the OTB TV network, 10 a.m. each Sunday. Should be a lot of fun. Anthony Mormino, Seth Merrill. We'll see you there.
I'm sorry, I went.
In a recent study of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTB's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTB mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to the Big A. Up first, three-year-old sprinters in the Bayshore.
They're off in the Bayshore. Your To Blame started well. Caledonian's got speed. Long Haul Bay, Theories on the outside. Even Thunder and Migsy as they race up the backstretch. It is going to be Even Thunder to grab the lead. Theory on the far outside, and Caledonian between those two is close up running in third. Long Haul Bay taken in hand on the outside of Migsy. They're 2.5 lengths off the lead. Your To Blame is trailing the field 7 lengths off of Even Thunder, who ran a quarter in 23 seconds flat and heads to the half mile pole 3/4 of a length ahead of Caledonian. Theory is third and just to the outside of the leaders. And then it's Migsy down at the rail. Long Haul Bay, fifth right now, still well in hand. 3 lengths to make up. Midway on the far turn, Your To Blame trails the field. Even Thunder rolling along here up front through a 46 3/4 mile. Theory is now a length behind and being ridden for more speed as Long Haul Bay begins to roll on the far outside and is charging up toward the front runner as they turn for home. Long Haul Bay draws up alongside of Even Thunder. Theory all out to stick with them. Long Haul Bay has taken the lead 1 furlong from the finish. Even Thunder is back into second. Not Theory today. Your To Blame is finishing well on the far outside, but Long Haul Bay's got it. Long Haul Bay, another very impressive win here, taking the Bayshore by 3.5 lengths over Even Thunder. Your To Blame finished well and was third, and Theory ends up fourth as the favorite. The final time was 1 minute 24.14 seconds.
Well, Unified won this race last year in his second career start, and now Long Haul Bay does it. Manny Franco in the saddle, the second choice for Chad Brown, returns $4.80. Even Thunder, co-longest shot on the board, finishes second. You're To Blame finishes third, and they're just on enough races to bet where Theory is the even money favorite. Up next, the mile and a quarter on the dirt, Excelsior.
They're off in the Excelsior. Very even beginning here. Two Brutus comes out running on the lead. Bellamy Way on the inside, away running in second, and then it's Sended In and Admiral Blue. Do You Know Something is fifth early on, just outside of Discreet Lover. Hereditary will do his running later, trailing the field about 10 lengths off the lead as they race for that turn. The Chilean Import in front. Two Brutus leads the way through the first opening quarter mile. It was a swift one, too. 23 and 2/5 seconds. Very fast for this mile and a quarter journey. And Two Brutus is going on with it here, opening up a 2.5 length lead onto the backstretch. Bellamy Way is running in second. Send It In his third. Admiral Blue fourth on the inside. Do You Know Something goes up in fifth, within 5 lengths of the lead. And then it's a 3-length gap back to Longshot Discreet Lover. Hereditary getting a good pace in front of him, trailing the field after a 47.5 mile. So they continue up the backstretch. Erad Ortiz Jr. and Two Brutus with a 2-length lead here. Bellamy Way is second. Send It In on the outside third. Do You Know Something? Right on the rail in fourth with a 0.5 to go. Then it's 3 lengths more back to Admiral Blue, Discreet Lover, and Hereditary. 3/4 up in 1:11 flat. They make their way around the far turn. In his U.S. debut, Two Brutus is taking it to them. He's got a 2.5 length lead. John Velasquez asking more from Send It In as Angel Arroyo switches Do You Know Something to the outside. And the others have work to do. And they have Two Brutus to catch as they come to the top of the stretch. Two Brutus turning for home with a 2-length lead in the Excelsior. Send It In bearing down on the outside. They're well clear. The others, Do You Know Something, is third. It's still Two Brutus. He's holding on to the lead here. Send It In continues to try, and he's getting closer once again. Two Brutus, here comes Send It In. And he runs by to win the Excelsior by a neck. A great U.S. debut for Two Brutus, who was second best. And it was a long way back to Do You Know Something. Hereditary was fourth.
Well, Todd Pletcher gets the money here with Johnny V, the even money favorite. Send It In scores the victory by 0.5 over the ever-tough Two Brutus, making the United States debut, setting, I thought, strong fractions in this race. Finishes 14 lengths in front of Do You Know Something in the Excelsior. Up next, Grade 1 action. And on the handicap report, I thought this was kind of somewhere between a Grade 2 and a Grade 3, the Carter.
They're off in the Carter. Unified and Green Grotto came out running well. Green Grotto to the front. Unified's going to go right with him. Spartigatus is away running in third. Oceanite is fourth on the outside. Awesome Banner is fifth. Some 5 lengths off the lead early on. And then it's Tommy Macho who's down on the rail. King Kranz, All-Star Red, and Sasakaya. A long shot leads the way here in the Carter. It is Green Grotto and Krista Carlo out on the lead. And they went 22-2 for the first quarter. The favorite Unified kept close by Javier Castellano, 1.5 lengths behind with 0.5 to go. Ocean Knight is third on the outside. Spartigatus has the rail in fourth. King Kranz fifth. Awesome Banner between horses. On the inside is Tommy Macho. Sasakaya's got 7 lengths to make up. All-Star Red is last as Green Grotto rambles around the far turn in front by 1.5 lengths over Unified and Ocean Knight. A 45.3 mile. They're coming toward the top of the stretch. Green Grotto is still there. He's opened up a 2-length lead on Unified as they turn for home. And here comes Tommy Macho, who's closing through on the inside with a furlong to go. Green Grotto, Unified is closing on the outside. Now needing running room is Tommy Macho. He's got no place to go. He's trapped in behind horses. Green Grotto is still there. Unified on the outside. The two of them come down to the line. Green Grotto! Get it! Green Grotto and Krista Carlo have shocked them in the Carter at 54-1. Unified was second, Tommy Macho and All-Star Red.
And folks, I got to tell you, this is not red boarding. I just don't understand the price at this level for Green Grotto. I know it's a Grade 1, but the competition to me screamed Grade 2 or Grade 3. And Krista Carlo at 54-1. Scores the upset victory, $110 even. The 4-5 favorite, the aforementioned Unified, finishes second. Tommy Macho finishes third. Up next, downgraded to a Grade 2 as it was in the middle 90s, the Wood Memorial.
They're off in the Wood Memorial. Cloud computing was a step slow to begin, but Talion Runner goes out to the early lead. And True Timber goes with him. These two will set the pace in the Wood Memorial. Irish Warcry taken off the pace by Rajiv Mirage outside of Motown and then stretches Stone and Glen Richmond on the inside. Cloud Computing is second last and racing about six lengths off the lead and leading only bonus points onto the backstretch. So as they move on to the backstretch, Battalion Runner is the leader. Ran that first quarter mile in 23 2/5 seconds and is on top by a length. With True Timber the closest pursuer in second and Irish Warcry third to their outside. Then Motown, Cloud Computing's making an early run now. Outside of Motown within three lengths of the lead and then stretches Stone, Glen Richmond, and the trailer is bonus points. John Velasquez and the favorite Battalion Runner lead the field in the Wood Memorial through a 47 1/2 mile. They're on top by 3/4 of a length over Irish Warcry, who's now second to True Timber. Cloud Computing is fourth on the outside. Motown's under a ride now and struggling to keep up with the top four as they round the far turn. Irish Warcry sidles up alongside of Battalion Runner midway on the far turn, and Irish Warcry pokes ahead in front. Battalion Runner on the rail is second. Cloud Computing is 2 1/2 lengths behind and now put to the whip as they come toward the top of the stretch. It is Battalion Runner and Irish Warcry. 3/4 in 1:11 and 4. They're into the stretch. Irish Warcry on the outside's got a neck in front. Battalion Runner all out, second on the inside, 4 lengths back to Cloud Computing. Irish Warcry's in front because they come to the final 16th. Battalion Runner's not going with him. Then comes Cloud Computing down to the line. Irish Warcry has won the Wood Memorial under Rajiv Mirage. A 4-length score over Battalion Runner. Cloud Computing was third and True Timber was fourth in a final time of 1:50.91.
The other grade two prep, the Bluegrass, had a maiden winner. The grade one prep, the San Anita Derby, was about the slowest in 60 years. But Irish Warcry scores one for the good guys in the grade two Wood Memorial, wins by 3 1/2, sends Graham Motion and Rajiv Marah onto the Kentucky Derby, returning $9 even as the third choice in the wagering. Battalion Runner, the pace setter, the 2-1 favorite, finishes second. Also at 2-1, making the third career start, Cloud Computing. On right after the Wood Memorial, we have three-year-old fillies in the Gazelle.
They're off in the Gazelle. Miss Sky Warrior right to the front. Yorkie Pooh Princess away running in second. Full House is out in third and now moves up a spot into second, moving into the turn. And then it's Locked Down, who's right there to the outside. Oh, a tight spot there. And having to steady was Full House, who now will sit third and on the rail. And then it's Tiz Rayanna, Yorkie Pooh Princess, back running in fifth, about 5 lengths off the lead. And then it's Stay Fond on the outside of North End, followed by the trailers Aspen Hilltop and Rimandi Sempre Forte. 23 3 was the first quarter. And 1/2 mile. Then a break of another 3 back to North End, Stay Fond on the outside, and 4 lengths more back to Rimandi Sempre Forte, and Aspen Hilltop is at the back of the pack as they make their way around the far turn. It is Miss Sky Warrior, the leader, Locked Down a 1/2 length behind on the outside. The two of them go at it, clear of the others. Full House is running in third, 4 lengths off of them. Yorkie Pooh Princess follows in fourth, and the others are scattered behind as they come toward the top of the stretch. Miss Sky Warrior's in front, 3/4, 1:11 and 3, and she's off the turn in complete control here. Locked Down can't go with her. She's tiring in second. And then it's Full House on the inside. Yorkie Pooh Princess a distant fourth. An absolute runaway here for Miss Sky Warrior. Coming by the 16th pole with a 10-length lead, Paco Lopez never asked her to run in the Gazelle. Just romped home over Locked Down. Then Full House and Stay Fond.
Miss Sky Warrior dialed down to win by 13 is the 8-5 favorite for Kelly Breen and Paco Lopez. They return $5.30. Lockdown finishes second. Full House finishes third. On Sunday afternoon, a Paris Stakes race is up first. Older filly mares in the distaff.
They're off in the distaff. Kelso Kate comes out running quickly with Clip the Coupon Annie. These two out for the lead together. Indulgent came out running in third. Highway Star is fourth early on, racing on the inside, and Carumba will settle into stride back there in fifth. Six lengths off the lead, Tail for Ruby is last. Kelso Kate in front. Clip the Coupon Annie, three quarters of a length behind. Highway Star, third, and racing on the rail as they continue up the back stretch through that first quarter in 22 and 2. Then Indulgent, Tail for Ruby, and Carumba's last. Four and a half lengths off of front-running Kelso Kate, who heads into the far turn, a neck in front. Clip the Coupon Annie on the outside, draws even. They're right together on the lead. Indulgent's coming up to them now. Indulgent is taken third. She's a length behind and heading up toward the top as they make their way around the far turn. Here comes Indulgent on the outside. Clip the Coupon Annie. Giving way is Kelso Kate. Highway Star. Carumba's got a lot of work to do. Five lengths off the lead. The half was 45 flat. They're into the stretch. Clip the Coupon Annie and Indulgent. These two 1-2 as they come down to the eighth pole. And here is Highway Star coming up after them on the far outside. Indulgent in front. Highway Star closing in. And down toward the inside, Clip the Coupon Annie. Highway Star trying to catch Indulgent in deep stretch. Highway Star's gonna do it in the distaff. Beating Indulgent and Clip the Coupon Annie. And fourth was Kelso Kate.
Highway Star. Angel Arroyo in the saddle scores the victory, returning $12.60. Indulgent, the second choice in the wagering, finishes second. Clip the Coupon Annie finishes third. And Carumba, the 2-1 favorite, boy, listless, finishing fifth. And on Sunday afternoon, turf racing returned to New York after we were off the turf on Saturday. The Danger's Hour.
They're off in the Danger's Hour. And it's an early speed here for Catapult. And on the inside, there goes Il Segreto and now McKagan on the outside. And now it will be McKagan to grab the lead from Il Segreto. Edge of Reality's away running in third. Back into fourth position here is Catapult inside of Ira. Then comes Cage Fighter on the inside and Gold Shield last of them all. McKagan has made the front. McKagan ran a quarter in 23 and 2 and heads onto the backstretch, a length and a half clear of Edge of Reality. Il Segreto is third on the inside. Break of 2.5 back to Catapult, who races just to the inside of Ira, Gold Shield, and Cage Fighter together at the back of the pack. McKagan back to his front-running style today here at Aqueduct and leads the way by a length and a half of the backstretch. Edge of Reality and Il Segreto, the closest pursuers, second and third. The half was 46. And 3/5 seconds. Catapult follows in fourth, four lengths off of McKagan, moving for the far turn. Then Cage Fighter on the inside. Gold Shield starts to pick it up, and Ira. McKagan rambles around the far turn. He's got a 2.5 length lead now. Catapult is getting going quickly. Moves up alongside of Il Segreto to battle for second behind McKagan at the top of the stretch. Three quarters in 1:10 and 3, and McKagan's got a 3-length lead. Catapult trying to cut into it with 1 furlong to go. Cage Fighter is third. McKagan still 3 in front. Catapult is second, and then Cage Fighter on the outside. McKagan by 2.5. Catapult still closing in but running out of time. McKagan and Catapult. McKagan on his favorite course scores at the big A. Catapult was second, and then came Cage Fighter and Gold Shield.
McKagan on the Aqueduct turf with the rails up, second choice, returned $7.60 for Mott and Carmouche. Catapult, the even money favorite, finishes second. Cage Fighter finishes third. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off Track Betting.